Now, Dylan Alcott made history this year when he won all tennis Grand Slams as well as a gold medal in Tokyo, meaning he's the only man to have won what is called the Golden Slam.
Yeah, he's been named one of Victoria's Australian of the Year nominees, and the legend himself joins us now from Melbourne. Dylan, great to see you again, pal. What a year you've had. Your winner mentality, you would have been set for this, but it's a different thing achieving it. Is the Golden Slam something you ever thought you would that would happen?
No chance, to be honest. You know, it's been such a difficult year for everybody. I just felt really lucky that I was able to go overseas and do my job, to be honest. And I just kept reminding myself that. But to never have a bad day and to be able to get it done was pretty cool. I was pretty proud of it. But to be honest, just the response that I got back home has been, I'm actually a bit lost for words still, to be honest. It hasn't really hit me. And however, I am, you know, it was my dream. The Paralympic Games saved my life, to be honest. So to get the gold medal, you know, during a pandemic was pretty special. And to get all the slams as well, I was pretty happy. Look, I carry it around. It's pretty much with me at all times. So there you go. That's with a shiny little bling. So, yeah, pretty stoked.
Oh, that is so brilliant. Most of us in lockdown just spent time baking bread, and here you are beating the world at everything. You just mentioned it before, but you said after winning the Golden Slam that you used to hate your disability and yourself until you started actually playing tennis. So do you think that's kind of what saved you?
Oh, 100%. I mean, being a good tennis player is probably the 32nd priority on my life. It really is. You know, being a good person is number one, a good family member, a good partner, but also being a good, you know, advocate for my community. And my real purpose in life is changing perceptions so people with disability can live the lives that they deserve to live. And not just in sport, in employment, in education, in travel, in dating, you know, in everything. And, you know, that's why I get out of bed every day, and sport's giving me that platform to do that, you know, what I am most passionate about, which I love. And that's why, you know, I've got so many, you know, different things on the go, because I'm just trying to use my platform, even in a very, very, very small way to make a difference.
Oh, small way to make a huge difference. Yeah. I love listening to you speak about anything. You must be pumped because you're hosting Ability Fest in Melbourne.
Yeah, just because I'm not busy enough, I'm going to chuck in a music festival. So this is our third rendition of Ability Fest. It's a music festival just like any other festival, Beyond the Valley, Coachella, whatever it is. We just have some added accessibility features so people with a disability can come with their able-bodied mates and have an awesome day. And 100% of the proceeds go to the Dylan Alcott Foundation, where we help young Australians achieve their dreams through university scholarships, sporting equipment, wheelchairs, prosthetic legs, startups, whatever it is. And yeah, we're really excited. Obviously, with everything going on in the last 18 months, we've had two false starts, but we've worked closely with the Vic government and the City of Melbourne to make sure that it gets up on November 27 this year. As I said, it's going to be right smack bang in the middle of the city on the Yarra in Alexandra Gardens. And not only have, you know, the music industry had such a, and the entertainment industry had a really tough 18 months, we're really looking forward to kickstarting that. But also, a lot of people with disability who may be immunocompromised, they've been in lockdown for 18 months, not being able to do anything.
Yeah.
And with the higher vax rates and the ability for people with disability to get the vax as well, we're really excited to, you know, if you want to come, you know, we're going to be fully safe in a COVID-safe way to put on an awesome day and raise a lot of money in the process.
This is actually fascinating, this festival, and how you've put it together. You've overcome huge challenges to actually put it together. I've been to a few music festivals in my time back when I was young and impressionable. How wild does it get at these festivals?
Well, it gets loose. Plenty of wheelchair crowd surfing. Don't worry about that. One thing I love, so, you know, you might think, what kind of features do you need, right? So we have pathways, platforms. We have Auslan sign language interpreters signing every single lyric spoken on the main stage, which is awesome. We have a quiet chill zone for people with sensory disabilities, for example, like autism, to come check out the show and have a place where they can retreat if they need it. We've got everything. But it's just a sick party, to be honest. Yeah. Like, that's the best part about it. So apart from all the features, it's going to be an awesome day. We've got Peking Duck, Illy, What's So Not, Alex the Astronaut,
awesome.
Me in Las Vegas. We've got artists with disability playing on the stage as well. So, yeah, as I said, it's all going to a good cause. So if you haven't got your tickets, you better hurry up, because they're selling pretty fast, and I'll be there Having a blinder as well. Looking
and the first major festival will be kicking off in Victoria as well. It's fantastic.
Isn't life looking peachy for you? Yeah. Golden Slam, you're all loved up with gorgeous Chantel, and you've got this festival ready to rock out at. For details on Ability Fest, you can head to abilityfest.com.au. Dylan Alcott, you are a superstar. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks so much. You guys have been big supporters of me. I always appreciate coming back. Thank you.
Keep making a difference, buddy.
Take it easy.